Hello, I'm David Pevalin and welcome to this online resource about socioeconomic classifications. In this resource there are two videos. The first one is an abridged history of official and academic social classifications, scales and schemas that have been used in the UK, and the second video is an deep dive into the National Statistics Socioeconomic Classification, the current official classification for the UK. Before I start, I have to recognise the work of Professor David Rose in this. I worked firstly under the direction of Professor Rose and then with as a colleague throughout the last 20 odd years on the National Statistics Socioeconomic Classification, and much of this would not have been possible without him. So to start with, I'd like to start with the official measures of official socioeconomic measures. So these are the ones that have been adopted by the Office for National Statistics and all its predecessor organisations. And the one most widely known is the Registrar General Social Class, or RGSC. Its name was changed in 1990 to social class based on occupation, but it's still commonly known as RGSC, and that's how I'm going to refer to it in this video. It was initially introduced in 1913, but substantially modified in 1921. And before it was discontinued, it was described as a graded hierarchy of occupations ranked according to skill. But this description of RGSC changed in 1971. Before that, it was described as reflecting occupations standing in the community, and it's not clear how this reconceptualization of RGSC impacted on the allocation of occupations to the classes. Along with the changes of the reconceptualization in 71, a number of changes have been made at each census after 1921. And these tended to be on the basis of judgments made by the Registrar General's staff, and it's really quite opaque about that process and why changes were made or what evidence was used to for the basis of these changes or for the allocation of new occupations as they came up. Saying that, however, the RGSC was widely used in government and academic research and a key measure in describing health inequalities in the mid to the late 20th century. But while at the same time that it was being extensively used, producing valuable insights, there was a developing dissatisfaction with the RGSC on theoretical, conceptual and technical grounds. And it led some epidemiologists and sociologists to use other socioeconomic indicators in their analyses. By the time we got to the ESRC review of government social classification in the mid-1990s, there was a plethora of papers and book chapters calling attention to the problems of the RGSC, and especially an increasing recognition that the RGSC described an industrial society and economy that was fast disappearing, and in which the old manual, non-manual divide was of less and less relevance. It was officially discontinued in 2001 when it was replaced by the NSSEC. But in this timeline, I put a shaded area after 2001, where myself and Professor Rose have unofficially continued producing derivation matrices for RGSC, especially for people who are using longitudinal studies and may have used these measures prior to 2001, so to offer some form of continuation of measurement for 2001 up to the present day as we have developed matrices based on the occupational classifications in 2000, 2010 and 2020, and these should all be in the UK data archive soon. The classes in RGSC are shown in this table here, as you can see, there are five classes, of which class three is split into three manual and three non-manual, and that dividing line is where you see a manual non-manual divide dichotomy in a number of analyses or using our GSC. There is actually a sixth class, which is for the armed forces, but they are normally dropped out of analyses or descriptive statistics using our GSC. You can see there are rules for where occupation, where foremen or supervisors are dealt with, and managers as well. Now, if we turn to socioeconomic groups, which was another official socioeconomic classification, it was introduced in 1951 and extensively amended in 1961, and it was introduced alongside RGSC. So from 1951 to 2001, there were two official socioeconomic classifications. Now, socioeconomic groups aim to bring together people with jobs of similar social economic status. And while socioeconomic groups were a more social scientific measure, which is not surprising given it was developed by David Glass, who was a social scientist with an interest in social mobility, there was still a lack of conceptual rationale or clear rules about how the many categories in socioeconomic groups could be collapsed into classes for analysis. And this led to many varied and inconsistent ways about how these categories were collapsed into classes in practice. It's also been said that socioeconomic groups partly relied on the outmoded distinction of the manual non-manual divide, and so was open to some of the same critiques as RGSC. So socioeconomic groups were also discontinued in 2001 with the introduction of the NSSEC, but again we have sought to continue the use of these measures from 2001 until the present day by producing our own derivation matrices, which hopefully will be available in the UK Data Archive soon. Now, if we move on to the NSSEC, I'm only going to talk briefly about it in this video because the second video in this resource is a deep dive into the NSSEC. So the NSSEC came out of the ESRC review of government social classifications, which was conducted in the mid-1990s, and it was officially introduced in 2001 based on the Standard Occupational Classification, SOC 2000. Although there's a SOC 1990 version that was used during the development of the NSSEC, the first official one is based on SOC 2000. The NSSEC was rebased on SOC 2010 and then on SOC 2020, and we'll go into more detail on those processes in the second video. The NSSEC is a nested classification, but the one adopted by ONS as its official measure was the 7 or 8 class version, shown here in this table. You can see that class 1 is split into 1.1 and 1.2, but class 8 is a sort of optional class because it can't be operationalized in every data set. Next on the timeline, I've put some of the main academic scales or schemas that have been developed, and I've split them left and right into those developed by John Goldthorpe and his colleagues, and those with on the right on to those that have a different conceptual basis to the Goldthorpe schema. I'm going to talk more about the Goldthorpe schema and its genesis and its input into the development of the NSSEC in the other video, So I'm going to concentrate more on those on the other side and the Hope Goldthorpe scale that sort of sits somewhere between the two, as John Goldthorpe was involved in it, but it had a different basis from his later schemas. If we start in 1950 with the Hall-Jones scale, this aimed to grade occupations according to their prestige, and it was used in many pioneering social mobility studies. However, the Hope-Goldthorpe scale in 1974 was designed specifically to remedy some of the issues with the Hall-Jones scale, and it ranked occupations in terms of their social desirability. The Hope-Goldthorpe scale was used in the early stages of the Oxford Mobility Project before it was abandoned for the Goldthorpe schema. If we now go to the Cambridge scale, this is a wholly different measure, and it's based on a scaling of occupational friendship and marriage, and it's regarded as a broad measure of social stratification and inequality. There's an extensive literature on the debates between the Cambridge group and the Goldthorpe group at Oxford on their relative merits and disadvantages of these two different approaches. Some have compared this to the Oxford-Cambridge boat race, but really there's so much difference between the two camps apart from their common interest in social mobility and social stratification. I mean, they have different takes on the theoretical basis, the conceptual basis, the measurement of their different schemas and scales. And this debate within the literature was given more impetus with the ESRC review of government social classifications and the adoption but adaptation of the Goldthorpe schema into the NSSEC, more of which in the other video. But in the early noughties, it died down a bit until in 2013, when the Great British Class Survey, run by the BBC and headed up by Professor Mike Savage, came along. I've put a number of different materials, YouTube videos in about this in the additional resources. Now, the Great British Class Survey, they argued that measures such as the NSSEC failed to capture the social and cultural processes that generate class divisions, and the data that they use and the concepts that they use to develop their classes say more about modern society than measures such as the NSSEC, and particularly about how people understand society and class divisions within society. They used a massive data set from an online web survey, but also a smaller national representative sample to develop their seven new classes. But there is a long discussion and critique about this, all of which are pointed to in the additional material.